some of the things that you do need to be careful of when looking to purchase property, particularly for investment purposes, is to make sure you understand how those tax implications affect different vehicles that you can use to acquire those properties. And very often without that knowledge at the outset, you often come into trouble right at the end when you're looking to sell the property, and that's when the serious tax implications arise. Choosing the right vehicle to invest in property will really depend on the purpose of why you're acquiring that property. And I'm always telling estate agents, you need to ask your buyer why you are looking to purchase that property. Some people are looking to buy it as their home, some are looking to buy it as their holiday home, some people are looking to flip that property and make money on the sale, or some people are long-term investors looking to buy it to let. So understanding what your client wants will help you determine which is the best vehicle. As a general rule, we like to think that holding your home in your individual name is the most tax efficient way, because you get a primary residence exemption on any capital gains tax that will be payable. And for long-term investment, always using a trust will be your best vehicle. So capital gains tax is really any tax that becomes payable on any gain that you make once you bought and then later sold an asset. And property is obviously one of those immovable assets that we look to buy and invest in. So it's a tax that's payable on any profit that you make, if you like, on that capital asset.